Hey guys, in today's video I'm going to be doing another makeup haul. I do a lot of these, but this one, I've got a spot and I just hit it. That hurt. I just felt that it was about time I updated you on what I've been purchasing recently. And most of the products I'm going to be showing you are high-end. I've been so excited to film this video because some of it I haven't used, and some of it I've even forgot about, and some of it I have used and have really, really loved. I don't want to go too in-depth with every single thing I show you because this is going to be a really long video. I haven't done a video which is solely to do with high-end products. I'm just going to stop rambling and we're going to go straight into this video. So first off, I am going to start off with a few high street products, and then I'm just going to grab what I can because it's all literally messed up. So I don't know what's in here, I've completely forgotten, and I'm just so excited to see what I did buy because half of it I seriously can't remember. So the first brand I'm going to start off with is Barry M, and they have released this new nail polish range and it's called Frosted Cupcakes. I picked up two. I got the shade Strawberries and Cream, which is this kind of pale pink, nudie pink with kind of like white, sugary, silvery specks of glitter in it. And then I also picked up the Blue Velvet, and this is kind of like a greyish blue with also the white, silvery glitter specks in it. So they are the two nail polishes. I think there's four in the range and I decided to go for those two. Next up, I have a Superdrug order, and I did get this quite recently, about 3 weeks ago, four. Okay, so this is a brand I've not tried before. I was going to do a video on me trying these products out, but I wanted to ask you guys first. So if you want me to do a video on the brand Models Own, I will happily do that. They did this deal where if you spent £8, you get the Barely There palette free on the Superdrug website, or if you bought it in store, you could get either the Sculpt and Glow free, this one free, and I think there was another palette free as well. I decided to pick up the Sculpt and Glow on the Superdrug website, and then I got the Barely There palette free, and I really like the look of these products. I did need a new contour kit, and I think this Sculpt and Glow kit looks amazing. I also decided to pick up a Sculpt and Glow highlighter. This shade looks amazing, and I really, really am I'm so eager to try this out because I want to see how it compares to the Mary Luminizer by The Balm. So I've got it in the shade Golden Sand, and that's the shade number one. And tell me this doesn't look amazing. It looks so pretty and I'm so excited to use it. What I really like about Models Own's like palettes and packaging is that they're magnetic, and I quite like that. I've seen Models Own brand stand in Superdrug plenty of times, but I've never really decided to look at any of it until I saw this deal, and I was like, okay, yeah, that will make me try it. I mean, it's only £8. The Barely There palette, let me show you what that looks like. So this is the Barely There palette. It's more of like your rose golds, nude shades. You have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 matte shades, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 shimmer shades, and it comes with a cute little brush. And then I'll quickly show you the Sculpt and Glow. I got this in the shade medium because I did see the light palette in store and I thought the blush was too pale for me, like it was too pink, and I wanted a blush that was a bit more mauvey, and the highlighter was a bit pale as well, and I love my gold like highlighters, and this is right up my street. So this blush is not quite pale, like too pale pink, but it's like a rose gold, and in fact, yeah, it has like a gold kind of shimmer to it. It reminds me of the NARS Orgasm blush. And then we have Light Up. Again, I'm going to be comparing this to Mary Luminizer. It looks a lot darker than the Mary Luminizer and perfect for that sun-kissed look. And then we have Sculpt, which is obviously the contour Sculpt shade, and that I just love it. It is medium, isn't it? Medium to tan. Next, I have a package from Beauty Bay. What I got was a lot of bubble wrap. Now you guys, if you've watched my videos for long enough, you know how much I love the brand Zoeva, and I decided to finally get the Rose Golden Blush Palette, but I know it's mainly highlighters, I think. I feel like it is. But this packaging is just gorgeous. Oh dear, the cover's gone. This is what it looks like inside. And yeah, it's gone. I'm just gonna have to leave that off because it keeps falling. The protector cover just keeps falling off. So this is the Rose Golden Blush Palette. In my opinion, it's more of a contour and highlighting palette. You have the top shade, which is Heavy Crown, so that's more of like a contour, and that's a matte. Yeah, it's a matte shade. And then the one in the middle is called Glowing Still, and that is a gorgeous like yellow-based white highlighter. And then we have Palace D'Or. Yeah, Palace D'Or, which is this rose gold blush highlight, I guess. It's more of a highlight. I don't know. I could use it as a blush. I really, really like the look of that. So the brand Zoeva never really do like a full-on Christmas range where it's like Christmas themed, but when they sneak previewed this on their Instagram page, my mind was blown. So this is called the Zoeva Plaza, and there are three eyeshadow palettes in here. That's the outer cardboard packaging, and then it comes in this cute little, looks like a jewelry box kind of design, but it comes, look at the gold. Oh, the eyeshadow palettes you get are Blank Fusion, Caramel Melange, I think that's how you pronounce it, and Cocoa Blend Palette. The Cocoa Blend Palette is hands down one of my favourite palettes ever, and because I already have the palette, I gave the one that came in this to a friend who has never tried Zoeva before, and I thought you have to seriously try this brand. If you are gonna start off trying Zoeva out, I totally recommend the Cocoa Blend palette and see. It is loved. I love the combination of shades you get in this. You have like your warm to dark tones. This shade, Sweeter End, is gorgeous and pure ganache. Oh, love it, and freshly toasted. It's just, this palette's to die for. I love, love, love the Cocoa Blend palette. Next palette is the Caramel Melange. This is just so, so pretty. I think this half of the palette has to be my favourite, especially this shade here called Aftertaste. It's this burnt reddish orange, and it's just stunning. And then we have 182 Celsius, which is this like orangey base rosy gold, I guess, with like pure gold shimmer running through it. And then just this liquid center is like a pure rose gold. So the last one that you get in the Zoeva Plaza is this one called Blank Fusion. Not only do you get your nude matte shades, you get a combination of shimmer shades as well. I love how this one's rearranged. You have like your base shades, your shadow shades, and then you have all the different shimmer shades. And this one like killed me when I saw this one here. Which one, what is it called? It's called Visions of Gold. When I saw this one on Instagram, I was like, how can you make a shade that yellow based kind of gold? It's just and then this highlight shade called Noble. I love this travel inspired like purpley brown base shade. The really good thing about Zoeva is that they are so affordable. Sticking with the Christmas theme, I have the Too Faced Grand Hotel. I got that for Christmas from my beautiful mother, and what I bought just before Christmas, when the Too Faced Christmas range came out, I picked up the Christmas in New York Merry Macaroons palette, and this palette smells like macaroons. I mean, I ain't saying no to that. So I'm gonna show you what you get inside. Let me just say, I have used this palette, and I use this throughout the whole of December. Comes like this, and it has a lid. You take the lid off, and then when you open it, it has little ice skating scene. And then you have the Better Than Sex mascara. I'm gonna see if this one's any better than my original, because it really clumps up. And then down here, you have the eyeshadow palette. Again, you can just take this traveling with you. It's so sleek and compact, just like the Zoeva palettes. What I love about Too Faced palettes is that they're very coordinated, and I love how you can just on each row create a look, even like down or across. These shades go so well together. I think the Honey Lavender was the only one that was a little bit like chalky, but the rest are really smooth and blendable. My favourite shades were Banana Cream and Tiramisu. But yeah, I wore this throughout the whole of December. Love this palette. and I'm so glad I got it. Next up is a click and collect order that I collected from House of Fraser. There's so much bubble wrap. It's just still going. Okay. Look at that. Look, that's still going. Look, still going. It's gone. There's so much bubble wrap. This is the Cheekathon palette, and I have no regrets in buying this at all. For so long, I've been wanting to get the Hoola Bronzer and the Dandelion and Rockator blush. I am so happy that I got this because this is the price of two of Benefit's little compact bronzers and blushes. Like, you get every single one of the ones they've ever released up until this point, and you also get a little brush with it too. So there's all the shades on the back. I'll show you what it looks like inside. The classic Benefit kind of design. You open it, you get a beautiful size mirror. You get this little booklet and it tells you the different kind of looks you can do. You have the Dandelion blush, you have the Hoola bronzer, then you have the Rockator blush, and then you have Dallas, which when I saw this blush, I was like, man, that is gorgeous. And then we have this, again, like rosy gold blush, which is called Coralista. And then you get the little face powder brush in there as well. Love the design, and I love the fact that you can just have all of your blushes and contour in one palette if you're gonna go away. It is a bit bulky to take away, but money-wise, it's worth it. So last year when I went to Derby to visit my friend Ilya, I picked up the Batter Up eyeshadow stick in the shade Curveball, and I wanted to see how they compared to the Kiko eyeshadow sticks because I really love the Kiko eyeshadow sticks, and when I saw Curveball, can't get the lid off, there we go, it's this gorgeous, just stunning gold. Can you see that? It's just a stunning creamy beautiful gold. I love their Mara Luminizer highlighter, so if these are any good, I'm so gonna get some more. Back onto Too Faced, I picked up the Too Faced Melted Matte in Drop Dead Red. It's just like that burgundy red. I love it. So if you watched my Star Trek matte collection video, you will know that I have been waiting to get my hands on the Strange New Worlds Trip the Light Fantastic Powder. And I made a huge American order with my friend Alia. This is basically what's going to be next, all the things that I got in this American haul. And I picked up this from America because it was out of stock in my local MAC store and on Debenhams and on the MAC website, so I couldn't get my hands on it. I would wear this as a highlighter or maybe even an orangey bronze shade in the summer. I love all the other powders in the range, and I really wanted this to complete it because it's just such a gorgeous shade. Sometime last year we had the Trolls Matte Collection released, and I only picked up one eyeshadow from the range. I still haven't seen the film, just thinking about that, I still haven't seen the film. But what I love about this is that you have a little troll in the centre of the eyeshadow. It's so friggin' cute, and again, it's an orange coral toned eyeshadow, and I love my coral orange shadows. MAC released a Nutcracker range, I think in November, December time. There was only really one thing that caught my eye from the range. This was the one thing I was so eager to get. This is called the Nutcracker Sweet Copper Face Compact. It's an extra dimension skin finish. And can we just take a moment to appreciate this packaging? I mean, it's like, this is embroidered. The gold you see on this packaging is embroidered. It's magnetic as well. Look. Oh. So, what you get is two gorgeous shades. So this is like your blush shade and then this freaking amazing gold highlighter. It's like a champagne gold. And then you have a mirror as well. And seriously, I cannot wait. This next palette I've been wanting for about 4 or 5 years, or ever since it was released basically. And it was so hard to get my hands on it. So when I found out that me and Alia could make this big American order, it was the first thing on my list. This palette is the Too Faced Peanut Butter and Jelly eyeshadow palette. This is what I live for, palettes that smell of peanut butter. Every shade in this palette I'm gonna use. Now I look at it, it looks very similar to the Too Faced, the Macaroons palette. You can smell the nuttiness, it's just I love these kind of tin solid packaging that Too Faced does as well, because I'm not going to worry about it as much as I would if it was a cardboard packaging. The next thing in my American order, I got the Anastasia Beverly Hills Glow Kit in the shade Sun Dipped. This is probably the best highlighting kit I own. The great thing about this is how big these pans are. Just these four shades are the shades that I would normally use as a highlighter. And seriously, if you haven't used highlighters, what are you doing? You need to try them. If you're scared, just try them. They're so good. Eyeshadows and highlighters are my favourite thing in makeup. Also in my American order, I picked up a few products from Becca. I've never used Becca Cosmetics. I've always wanted to try them, and when I finally had the opportunity to buy them, I did. You can get them in the UK. The first thing I have here is the Shimmering Skin Perfector Luminous Blush in the shade Tiger Lily. You just open it and you just want to put it on your face. This is probably the coral blush I own. Also from Becca, I picked up the Shimmering Skin Perfector Pressed in the shade Rose Gold. And this is a bigger pan because it's a highlighter. Rosy, gold, champagne-y. I just love rose gold highlighters. Anything gold and rose gold, I love it on my face. The next thing I have here is the Urban Decay Naked Illuminated Trio palette. I've never used a highlighter from Urban Decay before, and it's Urban Decay. I've never found anything wrong with Urban Decay to this date. Touch wood. I have noticed a lot of bad reviews for this online. I think it's because it's so glittery. Highlighters are not supposed to be really glittery, it's supposed to be shimmery, like reflective. So I understand why a lot of people don't really like this. So if you don't like glitter, you're not really going to be a fan of this. Let's just take that off because you're just screwed, aren't you? So good size mirror. I love the fact that it comes with the brush, but they are beautiful. And I do want to try them out a little bit more. Next, I have a Tarte package. I haven't even opened it. It's been that long, I haven't even opened it, and I cannot remember what exactly I ordered. Is that bad? Okay, we're in. Oh, Live Tarte filling. That's so cute. It comes in a package like this. Tarte wrapping paper, or packaging paper. Oh yeah! I forgot about this. I ordered the Tartlet in Bloom palette, and I haven't yet set my eyes on this palette at all because they don't sell Tarte in the UK. And why do they not? Like, it needs to be over here. This is smaller than I expected, but I'm quite happy because, again, I can take it travelling. So it comes with this little leaflet card which shows you different looks on how to use the Tartlet in Bloom palette. This packaging reminds me of the Makeup Obsession palettes, how it has this little clasp. And oh my goodness, it's your perfect nude eyeshadow palette. Every single eyeshadow has the word Tarte embossed in it. Yes, mate. I know someone who would love this palette. It would be my best friend, Katie. She would love this. It has so many matte shades in it. In fact, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. It has 9 matte shades and 3 shimmer shades. So, yes. I cannot remember what this is though. I don't know what this one is. It feels like another palette. Oh dear. I remember this! Oh, I raved about this for so long. I think I got this in August, beginning of August, before I went on holiday, because I do remember saying to my cousin Natasha and Aaliyah how I seriously went crazy over buying this. This is the most expensive thing, makeup-wise, that I've ever bought. This is the Becca Cosmetics Jaclyn Hill collaboration face palette, and this was sold out everywhere, and I really wanted to get my hands on it for months. I finally got a really great deal on eBay. It was still expensive, but much cheaper than what they were going for on eBay. I think it was about £10 or £20 more than its original price, but everything in here, if they were bought separately, would cost over £100. I think I got this round about for £59. On the back you have the lovely Jaclyn Hill. If you haven't watched her videos, please go and watch them, she's amazing. So yeah, in this palette you get Rose Spritz, so this is a blush, a very shimmery blush. Amaretto, it's a, I would say it's like a bronzer kind of contour shadow. And then we have, how the heck, Pamplemousse? I think that's how you pronounce it. Pamplemousse, this gorgeous pink, deep, mauvey blush. And then we have the Champagne Pop. And then this, Prosecco, I really can't pronounce names. Prosecco Pop, I think. How much fun am I gonna have with this face palette? It's just so pretty and I can't wait to use it. This mirror is friggin' amazing.
It's just a villain. I love mirrors that are this big. It's just...
This is like palette heaven.
Oh, what is this?
Oh, we get a sample of the backlighting primer filter. That's awesome. I was thinking about getting this on its own the other day. I'm so glad that comes with the palette because I can try it out. Dead happy with that. Just two packages left, guys. Two packages left. This next package, I do want to thank Hannah Curtis for putting up with me and Claire when ordering this. She lives in America and she is one of our closest friends. Back in February, March time of 2016, Katy Perry announced that she was going to be releasing matte lipsticks in collaboration with CoverGirl. So Hannah ordered the lipsticks that we wanted and then she shipped them out to us. And we are just so appreciative of this because there was literally no other way we could have got them. Here's a little note that Hannah put with it. She put, Katie, so sorry it took so long to send. I hope you are doing well. Love, Hannah. And I am doing well, Hannah. We have 5 shades. 3 of them are mine, and then the other 2 are my sister's. But I can't remember which ones is whose. I mean, looking at them like this, you can probably tell which ones are mine. So, my sister ordered Pink Pause, which is this very pale pink shade. It's like a summer spring shade, I would say. And I'm gonna wrap these up for my sister for her big package extravaganza, should we call it, and for when she returns. And then the other one is the Coral Cat, and they're just so pretty. The stickers like covered up the packaging on this one, but they all look like this. It says Katy Cat Matte, and then you have the Katy Perry with the little heart and CoverGirl on the back. I love them. The shades that I went for, I couldn't decide between 3 because me and my sister were gonna get 2 each, but I just had to get 3. I couldn't decide which one not to get. So the shades I went for were Maroon Meow, which is this burgundy purple shade. Absolutely looks stunning. And then I went for Couture, which is this kind of like peachy beige dark nude. It's a really nice shade. And then the last one is in this kind of like pinky nude and it's called Kitty Purry, and I just had to get that one. If you don't know already, my favorite eyeshadow palette of last year was the Too Faced Peach palette. When I had that was coming out, I had to get my hands on it straight away. I did. I love it. I recommend it to anyone. Since then, they re-released the peach palette in December. So, when I heard that they weren't only just re-releasing the palette, they were also releasing a whole collection surrounded by the peach theme. I went absolutely, I needed the range right now. You don't even have to like open this box to know that it smells of peaches. So, I have the Too Faced Papa Don't Peach Blush, and I love this. Look, just look how cute this is. It's adorable. I just, the peach with a smiley face, and look at the blush marks on its cheeks. It's just so cute. So this is a mauvey coral shade. It's a little bit darker than the blush in the Sweet Peach Glow Palette, which I'm going to be showing you next. And yeah, I just, again, it's another item that you just don't want to like touch or wreck because it says Papa Don't Peach and it has this peach inside the actual palette. And oh my goodness, I cannot wait to smell of peaches again. So the last item of this huge makeup haul is the Sweet Peach Glow Palette. As soon as I heard the Too Faced Peach Collection was going to be releasing a highlighting kit, I was like, you have got to be kidding me. A girl who loves highlighters and loves peaches is not going to say no to this. Again, it has the running peach packaging and... So this is the highlighter, I presume. This is the blush and then this is the like bronzer and they look so creamy. I want to touch it but I don't because I really want to take photos of this. I love this Sweet Peach embossed little peach that sticks out of the blush shade. It's so cute. I love it. That is the end of this video. If you enjoyed it, please give it a thumbs up, please subscribe to our channel and comment below. If you have any of these products and if you've used them, please let me know in the comments because I'd love to know what you think of them. And also, I would love to know what you would recommend me to try out. I love you guys and I will see you again soon. Bye! Now I'm gonna put all this away. I'm gonna find room for it. Let's see how that goes. This palette is the two. Every shade in this eyeshadow. Oh, what is going on there? I did want to get her famous champagne pop separately, but where did that go? Just put this back on. Sorry guys, that's my alarm to take my tablet. I'm on some medication and I need to take it, so. Okay, shush. Too Faced Papa Don't. Blah. So I have the. Get your words out, Kate.